Around the end of summer, I had a center console fall into my lap. Unfortunately, another Range Rover over on the East Coast was totaled after flipping to avoid a deer. But lucky for me, I was able to grab a piece of the Rover that I've never had. This will be another multi-part series where I break down the piece into the individual components and restore them to their former glory. Typically, when I tackle something like this, I start out the same way. Hunting down screws, brackets, and any possible connection points where they mount to one another. I'm always surprised to see things like staples being used in cars when nuts and bolts are more globally visible. The veneered plywood pieces could easily be sanded down and resealed, but I'd like to go with some leftover walnut sheets that I still have from refinishing the dashboard earlier this year. Overall, most of the components were in pretty good shape, though since the center console is located above the transmission tunnel, it tends to go through a lot of hot and cold temperature changes, making the plastic deform and break apart. These will likely be the hardest bits of the repair process, as I want to make sure they have more longevity. As for the vinyl wrap, I used a heat gun to make the adhesive pliable again. If you end up doing this method, I would recommend using it sparingly. If you stay in one area for far too long, the plastic will get too hot and begin to deform. As for the plywood, I started out using an angle grinder with a wire wheel, but quickly switched to a chisel to break off the finish. I think I'll leave it here for this episode. In the next, I'll go through re-veneering the plywood, cleaning up the metal components, and repairing all the plastic bits. And lastly, if you'd like to support the channel, I've recently built out a modest shop that I'll continually be adding new items to. And if merch isn't your thing, you can always join my Patreon. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you.